Meanwhile, today also marks 100 days since the Newman government came to power. The Premier and local members claim they've reached set goals, the Sunshine Coast holding a third of the power in the ministry.
Candu gave himself 100 days to prove to Queenslanders they made the right decision, electing the LNP with such a massive majority. And the Sunshine Coast has had a big role to play. Five local members in the ministry, as well as the first female speaker.
I'm proud to say that I believe we've made a good fist of delivering on all those things and getting the policy initiatives going we said we'd deliver on.
Among the promised actions ticked off, remove the $7,000 stamp duty on the family home, amend the Animal Protection Act for dugongs and turtles, and legislate tougher sentences for assaulting police.
Car registrations are now frozen. Stamp duty concessions have been reintroduced. Payroll tax thresholds will be increased, saving 5,000 businesses from paying payroll tax.
Look, mainly for the Sunny Coast, it's about cost of living.
As promised, Deputy Jeff Seeney visited the Merri Valley in May to address issues following the Traveston Dam debacle. In his first 100 days, the Premier is yet to visit the Sunshine Coast, but on day 101, that will change. Campbell Newman will attend a business lunch at the university tomorrow. Jessica Millward, Wynn News.